Welcome to Engineers Academy. Subscribe to my channel and click on the bell icon to receive the notification for the upcoming videos.
Now we are going to solve this problem 279 from the resultants topic. So in this problem it is said there are two rods. So these are two rods, one rod and the second rod, and one cable, and this is one cable, right? Are attached to the support at O. So it is attached to this support at this point O. Two of the forces are shown. So this one force is 500 pound. Let's suppose this is F1, and let's suppose this is F2. Determine the magnitude F and direction theta of the third force. So we need to determine the magnitude of this force and this theta, right? So that the resultant of the three force is vertically downward with a magnitude of 1200 pound, right? So the resultant magnitude is given. So we know the resultant magnitude, which is 1200 pounds, right? And it is said that the resultant of the three forces is vertically downward, right? So it is vertically downward. This is very important. So now if I draw that resultant, right? So this will be that resultant. Let's suppose if I draw it, it will be like this, vertically downward. So this will be that resultant. So let me write this resultant, and the magnitude of this resultant is 1200 pounds, right? So if this resultant is vertical, so then this means that the R x component is zero, right? There is no component of R along x. So this means that R x is equal to summation of all forces along x should be equal to zero. Right, so now if I resolve these forces into its components, right, so let me resolve these forces. So this will be the cos component of this F1, right? This will be the cos component of F2, right? And similarly, if I draw the component of this force, right, so let's suppose if this will be the cos component of this F force, right? So then this will be F1 cos of 30 degrees, right? This one will be F2 cos of 45 degrees, right? And this green one, right? So this green one, it is starting from here and ending here. So as theta, as this F is making theta with the vertical, so then this will be the sine component. So it will be F sine of theta. And we do not know F and theta, right? So now as we can see that if this is the positive X direction and this is the positive Y direction, so we can add these three X components, right? So this will be, so if we use this equation, so then we will write F1 cos of 30. So F1 is 500, so I will write 500 cos of 30 degrees, and it is in the positive X direction. So I will write plus this F2, so F2 is 1000, so I will write 1000 cos 45 degree, and this is also in the positive direction, right? And minus F sine of theta, so F sine of theta equals to 0, right? So I can write it like this, F sine of theta is equal to 500 cos of 30 degrees less 1000 cos of 45 degrees, right? So this will be F sine of theta. So F sine of theta comes out to be 1140 pounds, right? So this is one equation. Now the Ry should be equal to summation of all forces along Y, or the components of forces along Y will be equal to the resultant, right? So the whole resultant is vertical, right? So this is that second equation. So I will write summation of the all components along Y, right? So if I mention that components, right, so this one will be the sine component of this F1. So let me write, so this one will be F1 sine of 30 degrees. Similarly, the component of this will be in the downward direction, right? Since this force is acting downward, so this will be F2 sine of 45 degrees, right? And similarly, this will be the vertical component of this force. So this will be F cos of theta, right? Since the angle is made, if this is theta, so this is also theta, right? So the angle is made with this component, so this is the cos component, right? And we have assumed that this is the positive direction, so let's write this. So this one will, this one is positive, right? So I will write F1 sine of 30. So F1 is 500 sine of 30 degrees minus this F2 sine of 45. This is in the negative y direction, so it is 1000 sine of 45 degrees, right? And similarly, this one, this will be minus F cos of theta, and this will be equal to the magnitude of the resultant. This is the resultant magnitude, right? So this is 1200. Since the resultant is acting downward, so it is in the negative y direction, so we need to place minus sign here, right? So this will be minus 1200. So the summation of all the vertical components of the forces will be equal to minus 1200. This is the resultant value, right? So we can write it here according to the sign convention. So this R will be equal to minus 1200 pound, right? So this will be minus. This is minus, right? So if we solve this, so then F cos of theta comes out to be 742.89 pounds, right? So this is equation number 2. So now if we divide equation number 1 by 2, so dividing equation 1 by 2, so it will be equal to F sine of theta divided by F cos of theta will be equal to 1140 divided by 742.89, right? So this F will be cancelled out, which is not known, and sine of theta divided by cos of theta will be equal to tan theta. So tan theta, 1140 divided by 742.89, and if we take the inverse of this, so we will get theta. So theta is equal to tan inverse this thing, right? So tan inverse of 1140 divided by 742.89. So theta comes out to be 56.90 degrees, right? So this is a theta. So now this theta is known, which was asked in the problem, right? So theta is 56.90 degrees with the vertical, right? And now if we use either equation 1 or 2, so we will be able to find that F, right? So let me use this equation number 1. So if I use this, so then F will be equal to 1140 divided by sine of theta, and theta is 56.90, right? So F is equal to, so F comes out to be 1361 pounds, right? So if this is the F equal to 1361 pounds, and if this is the theta with the vertical, so then the resultant of all these three forces will be a vertically downward, and the magnitude of that resultant will be 1200 pounds, right? So this is the solution of this problem. Now we are going to solve this problem 280. So in this problem, it is said that determine the resultant R of the three tension forces acting on the I bolt. So these are three tension forces which are acting at this I bolt. So we need to determine the resultant of these three forces, right? And the angle theta x, which R makes with the positive x axis. So we need to find theta x angle, which the resultant will be making with the positive x axis, right? So now what we will do, we will find Rx. So Rx will be equal to summation of all the components along x, right? So if we resolve these forces into its components, right? So let me resolve this 20 kilonewton force into its components. So right, this one will be one component, right? And similarly, this one will be the vertical component of this 20 kilonewton force. Let me write that this is f1. So this will be f1x and this will be f1y, right? And similarly, if we resolve this 8 kilonewton force, let's suppose if this is F2, right? So if I resolve this force into its component, so then we will have this one component. Let me draw it here. So this will be, this green one will be F2x, right? And similarly, the vertical component of this F2 will be in this direction, right? Vertically downward. So this green one will be f2y, right? So as we can see that if this is the positive x direction, if this is the positive x direction and this is the positive y direction, right? So this f2x and f1x are in the positive x direction, right? So then the summation of forces along x will be equal to f1x plus f2x, right? And the third force is vertical, right? So this is F3. So F1x is 20 sine of 30 degrees, right? So as we can see that F is making 30 degrees with the vertical, right? So this component will be the cos component. So it will be F1 cos of 30 degrees, right? So it will be the sine component. So F1x will be the sine component, right? And similarly, this F2 force is making 45 degrees with the vertical. So this this F2 is also making 45 degrees with the vertical. So then F2y will be the cos component. So I can write that this F2 is the cos of 45 degrees, right? And similarly, this F2x is the sine component. So I will write F2 sine of 45 degrees, right? So here we can write that F1x is 20 sine of 30. So it will be plus F2. 8 sine of 45 degrees. So this will give us our x. So this is 15.66 kilonewtons, right? So this is our x. Similarly, to find our y, we will use this equation. So our y will be equal to summation of all the vertical components, and this will be equal to this component f1y, which is along the positive y direction, right? And similarly, this f2y, it is in the negative y direction. So I will write minus f2y and minus this f3. So minus f3. So our y will be equal to f1y. So f1y is f1 cos of 30, right? So this is f1y. So 20 cos of 30 degrees minus f2y. So this is f2y. So F2 is 8 cos of 45, 8 cos of 45 degrees minus 4 kilonewton, right? So we will get our y. So this comes out to be 7.66 kilonewton. So this is our y, right? And both our x and our y are positive, right? So this means that if I draw resultant here, right? So if this is the resultant, right? So then this is our x in the positive x direction and this is our y in the positive y direction, right? So this is our x and this is our y, and we know the magnitude of our x and our y. So this is 15.66 kilonewton and our y is 7.66 kilonewton. So now this is the theta x that we need to determine, right? So if we apply tan theta to this triangle, so this will be equal to tan theta x will be equal to ry divided by rx, and theta x will be equal to tan inverse ry. So it is 7.66 divided by 15.66. So this will give us theta x. So this comes out to be 26.06 degrees with the positive x-axis, right? So this is that angle, 26.06 degrees. So now if we write this r resultant in a vector form, so this will be equal to rxi plus ryj, right? So this will be equal to 15.66 i plus 7.66 g, and theta x is equal to 26.06 degrees with the positive x axis. So this is the solution of this problem.